Hi, this is Cecilia from Tarot by Cecilia, and today is Thursday, October 22nd, 2020. The tarot card for today is The Lovers from the Light Seers Tarot by artist Chris Ann Donnelly. This really is a beautiful card, and whenever we see The Lovers come out, the Knight of Cups, the Two of Cups, everyone always wants me to talk about relationships, and I tend to talk about other things as well, and I'm going to do that again today. But with this card today, you know, there's just so much that's going on. The Sun will leave Libra. Libra's a relationship sign, okay? Most of the day you still have, yeah, can't even talk, the Sun at that last degree of Libra, okay? So there's definitely a focus on relationships, first of all. But later in the day, in the evening, the Sun moves into intense Scorpio. With Scorpio, things are not, let's balance them out. It's one way or the other. You know, there's no in between. It is your extreme sign. And with that extremeness comes passion. And the passion is not just about, you know, a love interest, although it can be. It's a passion and drive to, you know, want to do things, okay? Like, what are you passionate about? Some people, you know, have careers that they're working on, and, you know, it's wonderful when you can find the thing in life that makes you happy, makes you successful, and that you thoroughly enjoy doing what you're doing. So if you find yourself being more decisive and passionate about a current project, there you go. It's the Scorpio energy. But you do have to remember that you still have Mercury retrograde there in Scorpio for a few more days. It will be backpedaling into Libra on the 27th. And I spoke of decisions, and you know, this is actually a card of choices. Sometimes it's with relationships, sometimes it's maybe decision making with a partner and choices that need to be made. But one of the biggest reminders that I always feel comes with this, and Mercury retrograde plays a big factor in this right now, because with Mercury retrograde, we tend to review things, okay? Like everything. Could be an old love that comes back from the past, and you have to think, was it worth it? Because most of the time there's a reason that they're in the past, okay? And they may not have a place in the present, but occasionally they do. And herein lies the choice, okay? I don't know how many of you out there feel like when you're in a relationship or every time you begin a new relationship that you wind up with the same result, or it always ends the same way and you don't get what you're looking for. And my thing is, if you keep on doing what you're doing, you're going to keep on getting what you're getting. And you know what that means is, sometimes we think in our minds that we know exactly who we want and what we want, you know, how they should look, how they should act, how they should treat us. But in the end, it doesn't work out that way. And when this keeps happening repeatedly, the universe is trying to tell you it is time to choose something different. So use this review period that's here and this lover's card that's here to be able to do that. And there's one more thing that I want to bring up when it comes to, you know, love and the lover's card and, you know, the universe itself right now. That's always very key how these things play out. Venus is in Virgo. And it's not a place that Venus likes to be, first of all. It can't wait to get into Libra and be home. But nitpicky, particular, critical, okay? If you find yourself feeling that way about someone, don't make any rash decisions, okay? Because it could very well be Venus in Virgo causing you to just like pick a person apart, pick the relationship apart. It's one thing to be reviewing it or to be passionate about something, but it's quite another to be criticizing. to be finding fault. And unfortunately, that is a not so nice trait that comes with that. But you know what I think you can do is just hang in there, because on the 27th, when Mercury retrograde moves into Libra, a few minutes later, Venus will be joining in, okay? And I think you'll have that balanced relationship vibe. So don't let any of those things affect you today, okay? We do have an eclipse season coming up, and you know, it's going to have a lot of relationship stuff involved with it as well. And some of you out there may be beginning to feel that it's a little bit early, but before you know it, we will be talking about it. So all things relationship are included here today. How we choose our relationships and the passion and the drive that we have for what interests us most in our lives. I want to thank you all very much for being here. I'll see you here again tomorrow. And as always, have a great day.